Atreus, follow me.
Sorry, I'm distracted. I still can't read these.
From here.
That way, behind the big statue of Thor. How about one more story?
Very well. There was the story of the mother crab, who scolded her son. She told him he should walk forward, in pride, not sideways as he always did.
But she's a crab too. You should say, sure. I'll look for it as soon as you show me how.
Yes, you did say that. That was the story.
I got it.
Boy.
Yes, sir. time.
Face me, God of Thunder!
Your challenges mean nothing to the gods, Spirit. They do not listen.
Do not mock my pursuit of vengeance. Though my family devoted their lives to worshipping Thor, I've devoted mine to his downfall. And I will start with that statue looming over my father's grave.
Unlikely. You are dead.
Is there something we can do?
For a reward, of course.
If you bring down the statue, you have my blessing to loot my father's grave. He rests on an island to the east.
Why do you hate Thor so much?
After my father passed, my mother built the statue to watch over his grave. Imagine our surprise when the God of Thunder himself came to offer condolences. At first we were thrilled, but he quickly took advantage of our hospitality. My mother begged him to leave, and Thor, in his drunken rage, killed her. I was left with nothing but grief. Eventually, I lost that as well, and found only rage in its place.
I'm so sorry.
Come, boy. We have a statue to destroy.
Ah, very smart.
My father's grave lies on an island to the east. Do not mistake my mother's statue of Thor with that monstrous eyesore to the south. cannot rest while my mother's murderer stands above my father's grave. That spirit.
The one whose mom was killed by Thor? What about him?
Let his story be a reminder. The lives of men mean nothing to the gods.
I know, Father.
You know. But do you listen?
Yes.
Good.
Got another story?
Very well. There is a tale about a woodsman. He asked the trees of the forest for a branch to make a handle for his axe. Instead, the trees gave him a young sapling so they could keep their limbs. The woodsman made his axe, and then he returned and chopped down the oldest trees in the forest.
Just because trees are old doesn't mean they're smart.
Boy.
Vaithargar. Southern outposts of the Dwarven King. Dwarven King? Have you ever heard of a Dwarven King?
No.
Let's do it. We got that taken care of. I see. Just wanted to stare into my eyes.
Looks like we got him off.
Oh!
What happened to these people?
Follow the clues.
Okay. Well, scorch marks. They're all grouped together. So maybe they were hiding from some kind of fire breather. But they died anyway.
It is over. Read it.
Yes, sir. Veda Dauther. It means hunting death. Great.
Here. Boy.
Sir. Curse the Dwarf King. Bane of mankind. Sounds like he wasn't a very good king. I wonder why they hated him so much.
They are dead now. Does it matter?
Nah. I'm just curious.
Curiosity is dangerous, boy. Stay focused.
How do you even begin to build statues this big?
Dwarves are resourceful creatures. Annoying. But resourceful.
I guess they must have been pretty important dwarves. So, what other stories have you got?
One more. Old one. We will finish that later.
Okay. Do you hear that? There's a Thor statue on that island. That must be where the spirit's father is buried. Well, here it is. It's gotta have a weak point. Somewhere. His father's grave. Find anything good?
Perhaps.
Father, we're going to bring down that statue, right? We're really just going to loot his grave and leave? There he goes! How's he planning on doing this himself?
Easily, boy.
I know. I was just joking.
Nor are they a joking matter.
Sorry. Father, why did the gods cause so much trouble for us?
Because that is their nature.
But with all that power, you would think at least some of them would try to make life better for people.
And yet, the gods continue to spread misery. This is life, boy.
Got any more short and purposeful stories from it?
Very well. We will continue another time.
Good.
Atreus, to me!
Thank you.
over. It is over.
Concern us.
I know, but it's what Mother would have wanted. And it just seems right.
Guard your emotions, boy. Your enemies will not hesitate to use them against you.
Yes, sir. Small settlement. I thought you said it'd be dangerous to destroy the other ones.
If it was your mother's wish.
Yeah.
You are too eager, boy. It may attack us, and we will be forced to kill it. We'll see.
Yeah. actually was a pretty big city.
No longer.
Stay down! More of those. Good.
Thank you.
Look here.
Yes, sir. Okay. That's going in the journal. That solves that question, Matt. Her, the great huntress. That's her father, and all the animals she hunted. And the last panel, her father again. Both of them, in the snow.
Thank you.
at this place.
A ruin?
Well, yeah. But if a dwarf built it, they must have been impressive back when he ruled. Grateful or not.
Here, boy.
Yes, sir. Dwarf King made his subjects hunt dragons and other monsters for him? Some kid.
Again, boy.
I can't hear their thoughts. I can't.
Ignore them and
ready yourself.
Okay.
Yeah!
he's thinking now?
Well, nothing. But he was grateful to die in battle, instead of rotting in a cage.
Your skill is improving. You fought well, Atreus.
Thank you, Father. Ah, fresh air feels good.
Prepare yourself!
You got him. So, what happened to all the people who lived here?
Follow the clues, boy.
Right. Follow the clues. Okay, so there was an evil dwarf king, and he made all these people hunt monsters. The people put them in cages, and then... And then I don't know.
We are missing a clue.
Back inside the castle?
No. There is nothing more for us inside. But stay alert for chained dragons, boy. Perhaps you'll uncover more about this dwarf king.
Hey, Brock, you ever hear of a dwarf king?
I suppose you're talking about Motsignir? Some bitch ruled over the humans once lived in this area. Built itself a castle just north of here.
A dwarven castle? What's it like?
You got yourself a pair of eyes and legs, ain't you? Might want to stock up before you head that way, though. Old Motsignir's known for collecting all manner of killerin' creatures. Not sure who's looking after him now. What can I get you, you little fart? I'm sure that's a load off your mind. Son, you again. Where were we on that other thing?
So, what other stories have you got?
There was once a scorpion who wished to travel to the other side of a river. If you continue to interrupt, I will end the story.
Okay.
The scorpion asked the frog for help. He told the frog that if he gave him a ride across the river on his back, he would be rewarded. The frog protested, fearing the scorpion would sting him. The scorpion assured the frog that he would not sting him, or they would both drown in the river.
We will continue another time.
Good.
Another name.
Gairdrifol.
So did the frog give a ride to the scorpion?
We will continue another time.
Good.
Another name.
Air! Want to see what we can trade those for?
So did the frog give a ride to the scorpion?
The frog agreed. But halfway across the river, the scorpion stung him. The frog was mortally wounded, and they both sunk to the bottom of the river and perished.
That's sad. Why would the scorpion do that?
He was a scorpion. It is his nature to do harm.
Oh. That's just what Mom used to say about the gods.
Your mother always spoke the truth. Enough stories.
Fafnir went to Alfheim too?
I do not know.
Aren't you curious? He sounds interesting.
We go to the storeroom to collect anything useful for our journey, not to learn more about the dwarf.
Have you made it out of Fafnir's storeroom yet? To work we go. Yes, dear boy? Ah, isn't that neat? You don't have to run off on my account.
Must have gotten here first.
Yeah!
That takes care of that.
Locked. Find another entrance.
There's something up there. Now, where do we go from here?
Atreus, follow me.
Look here.
Another map. Bet we'll find something useful here. Looks like the Reavers made it inside. I hope they didn't take all the treasure.
Thank you.
magical treasure and know what stuff.
Keep your expectations low, boy, and you will never be disappointed. Caught you off guard.
I wasn't expecting them.
Exactly.
Stupid bird statue.
And useful resources. The main reason we are here, boy. However, many of these chests have been emptied.
Probably by the Reavers. I hope they didn't take Sindri's whetstone.
Remember what I told you about expectations, boy.
Keep them low. I remember. Still, good feeling.
Yeah!
much for my good feeling. This time.
I saw.
So I should keep my expectations low, but always expect an attack?
It is a delicate balance. Expect the worst, assume nothing, and always anticipate an attack.
Sure is a lot to remember. Whetstone. And only one room left. I know I shouldn't hope, but do you think we'll find it there?
No.
piss on. So, you back to piss on my corpse, you ungrateful little. Who are you two?
We're looking for a whetstone. Have you seen it?
Aye, there was one in this room. My son sharpened his dagger on it right before stabbing me in the back.
What?
Little bastard thought it was his turn to lead my crew. I was hard on him, sure. Guess I shouldn't be surprised. I did the same thing to my dad when I was his age.
He killed his own father?
Where is he now?
He may be a bastard, but he's my bastard. You'll get no help from me, fool.
Then his dagger will help.
Hey! That's mine! Hey!
Come, boy. We are leaving.
Hold it behind you!
Choke on it!
A pair of pasty fiefdoms you sure can't fight. I'll give you that.
Like a great father, but
you only know half the story.
Yeah. Here we go. I'm ready.
Come on.
You, didn't happen to...
We found no whetstone. This dagger belongs to the Reaver who took it.
They took most of the good stuff.
Oh? Well, here, take this. In exchange for the dagger. The dagger you brought me is quite interesting. And... artless design, but the construction is sound. Where in the temple did you find this?
In a reaver's back.
Ugh. Oh.
He mentioned he was part of a larger clan. Maybe they took the whetstone?
Quite possibly. I know I've seen this design before. Travel safe, you two.
Roy, do you remember which is port and which is starboard?
Oh, I think so. Port is left, and starboard is right. Right?
Not your right. Where the boat faces, port is left, and starboard is
right. Right! I knew that. I did! never seen a waterfall so big.
You there? Have you destroyed?
The statue stands no longer, Spirit.
Then my bond to this realm is severed, and I am off to find the real God of Thunder. He will know retribution. My deepest gratitude.
Off he goes. Brave guy. Going to look for Thor on his own.
He is a fool.
What did the spirit leave us?
An offering to one of the gods.
Can we use it?
No, but perhaps the dwarves can.
Some statue. Who built it, you think?
I do not know.
What happened here?
Shipwreck.
Well, yeah. I wonder why it crashed.
Thank you. I see improvement.
This needs a different cipher than the one we have.
Port?
Sorry?
Port.
Oh, the boat's left.
Correct.
You want to dock here? Huh?
The water dropped.
And the serpent rose. Right. I knew that. I know she's really powerful. But you really think the witch can bring a head back to life?
She seems competent in her craft. And we have nothing to lose.
If she can't bring it back to life, can we keep the head?
No. But you may feed it to the fish.
Okay. I bet this will lead out.
Follow me, Atreus.
Thank you.
Boy, over here.
This is locked up good.
I see another one of those bowls of sand up there that I drew the runes into. Not sure how we reach it. I see something up there. Up there. See it?
Turn back Aesir. Guess the gods aren't welcome here. There he is! I hope he remembers us.
Boy.
Huh. Neat.
How's it going, Charlie? Is your witch friend here?
What is that name?
That's what he told me it was. What it sounded like in my head, anyway. Charlie.
Save!
What does it say?
Yes, sir. Say their neat things upon all who trespass.
What does it say?
Yes, sir. Death to the Raven Girl, Lord of the Hang. Another one of those sand bowls.
What does it say?
Falcon, hawk, and turtle dove. Swim aloft in oceans above. Huh?
Those runes, on the rock.
They don't spell anything. It's gibberish. Want me to read this one?
Those runes, on the rock.
They don't spell anything. It's gibberish. Father, she is here. It is so good to see you again. I knew you weren't dead.
Hello.
Oh, can you bring a head back to life?
I'm not sure I understand what... Wait. Where did you get those? The arrows. Give them to me, now.
They were a gift.
Do as she says, boy.
These arrows are dangerous. They're wicked. You find any more, you destroy them, understand? Do you understand? Say it!
I understand. If I see them, I'll destroy them.
It's all I ask. Forgive me. Please, take my arrows in their place. I have no need for them anymore. Now, what's this about a head? Do you have any idea who this is? Did you kill him?
At his request. He claimed you could revive him.
Me? Are you sure you heard him right?
Please?
Take him to the table. Hamelin! It's been a long time since I've practiced the old magic. Hold him there. Let's have a look. Well... thankfully, his head hasn't decayed much, and his brain is still intact. Nice clean cut. Cutting off his head of all people. I sure hope you know what you're doing. Now, hold his head under the water and don't let go. I mean it. That's enough.
It worked!
Let me see him. Mimir? You there?
Yes.
Good.
Hello, Freya. Been a long time. You look well.
What I did for them. As far as I'm concerned, death suits you better.
I'd bow if I could, Your Majesty. Forgive me. Had I known the Witch in the Woods was Freya herself, I never would have suggested this.
Freya? The goddess Freya?
You didn't know either? Sorry.
When word gets out that Mimir is free, the wrath of Odin won't be far behind.
You are God.
Leader of the Vanir, once, yes. But no longer.
You did not think it important to tell me.
Are you really going to lecture me about that?
We are leaving, boy.
But...
Now!
You're welcome!
Why did you do that?
We cannot trust her.
Because she's a god?
Have I taught you nothing, boy?
But she's helped us a lot.
She lied.
Some people value their privacy. Best not to judge, brother.
When I require your counsel, Head, I will ask.
Fair enough. Get me to Tyr's temple in the Lake of the Nine, and I'll get you to Jotunheim as promised.
We know the temple. What's there?
Only the last living giant in Midgard. Who better to tell us the way?
The World Serpent? Wait, do you know how to talk to him?
Indeed. He speaks an obscure tongue more ancient even than these mountains. None are left in Midgard who speak it. Except, of course, for me.
You do?
That's true. You wouldn't know it to look at him, but Jormungandr is a sparkling conversationalist.
So, Mimir, why did Freya spit in your face?
No. Speak of Baldur. He claims nothing harms him.
Aye. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
Boasting of a god. Everyone has a weakness.
Not him, I'm afraid. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
You just said that, Mimir.
Did I?
What is the source of this power?
Well, as I recall, it involved, spell?
Mimir?
Parts of my brain must still be coming back to life. Just need a moment to finish waking up.
I hope he's not broken.
Ben, how do we speak to the serpent?
There's a horn on a platform at the middle point of the bridge. Take me to it.
Finally! That horn!
Tyr would have been pleased as peaches knowing these offerings were being turned to armor.
Did you know him? What was he like?
Never you mind, boy. Tyr's dead. Best not to dig up the past.
The dwarf speaks wisely, for once.
Let's get you squared away, then. What'll it be, Shorty? You take care now.
I put my lip. You made in honor of Thor, and seeing as the world serpent absolutely abhors the fat dauber, he was probably sick of looking at it.
But doesn't that hurt?
Well, he and Thor have a bit of an unpleasant history between them. Or they will, anyway. So I guess waking up to see it was worse than the thought of lumps of solid stone passing through his gullet. You want me to ask him?
No. Our only concern is Jotunheim.
All right, wish me luck. I've still got it, lads. He remembers me. Why, you...
Listen closely now. We need two things to get us into the land of the giants. First, we need to learn the travel rune that opens realm travel to Jotunheim. Second, we need to carve that rune into the special gateway.
That one on the peak where we first met you?
Correct. Except the giants, in their infinite wisdom, saw to it that no ordinary chisel would do the job. Only the tip of a magical chisel opens that gate. Luckily, I know where it is, and it's not far.
He looked kind of mad for a moment there.
Now that, he thought I said you were friends of Odin. You'll forgive me. I've never spoken the ancient tongue sober.
Wait, look! The water's dropped even further. You can see more of the realm towers and statues. I haven't seen new places to explore along the shore.
Where is this chisel?
Find me a boat, and we'll go from there.
So when we get to the boat, we can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do. What's hiding behind there?
No earthly key nor physical force can get past the magic of that lock. Don't even look at it.
Never seen a lock like that before.
Reminds me of something I've seen Tyr sketch. He liked to combine various symbols into runes all his own. This one, I believe, means...
peace, unity, mercy. Other things, too. I see what he did, but how do we get inside?
We have other concerns.
It's locked magically.